What is going on, everybody? Estas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, looking at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're going to be talking about two trades that I made today on the 11th of February in 2019, as well as taking a look at some other stocks and ETFs, some other ticker symbols that I find interesting and that I'm watching for the rest of this week and for the rest of this month. So before we do get into the content today, guys, for all of you out there that do enjoy the channel, that do find value in these videos, feel free to hit that like button. It really does help the channel grow, and I really do appreciate every single one of you guys out there that are watching these videos, that are subscribing, that are watching religiously, and of course hitting that like button. It really does mean a lot to me. So let's talk about what happened today in the overall stock market. Well, today, guys, it was a pretty boring day in terms of the overall indices. We see here the SPX, the S&P 500, the largest 500 companies in the United States, publicly traded companies, was up only $1.92 today at the close, up around 0.07%. Not much movement at all. We'll take a look at some time frames in a couple of minutes on the SPX, but let's take a look at the Dow Jones on the day. Closed down about $53, down around 0.2%, so a bigger downwards move there in terms of the Dow Jones versus the SPX. The NASDAQ composite today, guys, down around $6.50, down around 0.09%. I called out a head and shoulder pattern in the NASDAQ early on this morning in the Discord group chat, and you know, it pretty much held that whole pattern throughout the entire day. And for those of you guys that don't know, a head and shoulder pattern very quickly is what we see right here, right? We can see this is the left shoulder, this is the head, and this is the right shoulder forming. So where we can go from here, guys, is potentially down, right? Potentially down. That is where this pattern is, looking like it's headed. But we'll talk about that in a couple of minutes as well. But let's hop right back to the SPX, the S&P 500 index. So for all you out there that don't recall, in yesterday's video and the video on Friday, we were talking about this channel that the SPX is trading in right here, pretty much drawn out by these trend lines, right? Over these past 20 days, really over the past, 30 days, 90 days, we've been, not 90 days, about 30, 40 days now, we've been uptrending. We've been seeing some straight up green bullish run here from the end of December in 2018, right? And pretty much from around, let's say, the 10th of January, we've been trading in this particular channel drawn out by the trend lines. We can see this is the support level of the channel. We can see it's held above there once, twice, three times, four times, five times, and it held above there today. And this is the resistance of the channel, right? We can see it bounced, got rejected on the 18th of January at the top here at around 26.75. And we topped off there last week on the 5th of February at around 27.38. So as of right now, guys, the fact that we did have, a flat day on the SPX, this is a pretty good sign that the uptrend is still intact. And let me tell you guys why. So what do we see here is we see that today we held the resistance from yesterday, or not yesterday, Friday, or not Friday, yes, Friday and Thursday, we held their resistances as new support levels. And let me explain this very quickly. On the 7th here of February, right, this was on Thursday, we topped off at around 27.05, later on in the day. And then the next day on Friday, we went all the way back to 27.05, making that the resistance over the previous 2 days. And the fact that we held those resistances as new support levels today, that is a good sign that we're A, moving up, making higher lows on the mini charts here, on the small term charts here, and B, we're holding that, 180, or rather the 50 SMA, or not 50 SMA, the channel support on this 20-day, one-hour chart, right? We're holding the uptrend still, and we can see here, guys, on this 20-day chart, we can see it a bit better. You know, the fact that we're making higher lows here, the low here at about 27.05, which was today, previous low at around 26.87, right, which was on Friday, this is a good sign that we're slowly climbing up. So what do you want to wait for and see for tomorrow for the continuation of this uptrend? Well, we want to see a break above this 50 SMA here, which is clearly a resistance. So right now, we're pretty much trading between this support level that we just talked about and this resistance at around 27.15. So we have about a 5 to 10 point gap right now in the SPX that we were trading today. So tomorrow, we're going to go two ways. Either two ways we're going to go tomorrow. The first way being above here, which is going to be the break of the resistance, the continuation of the uptrend, right? But if we break below, right, if we break the support here and we get back into the $2,600 range tomorrow, let's say we have a red day, what that is telling me is that we're slowly going to be downtrending with lower highs, right? Because of the high at 27.38, previous high at around 27.16. We could see a high around here at around 27.09. And if we keep going down, guys, that's going to be lower highs, which dictates a downtrending pattern. So tomorrow, it's going to be an interesting day to see, you know, where we're pushing here on the SPX. But as of right now, guys, that I'm recording this video, we are still uptrending in terms of the SPX. So taking a look at the Dow Jones, guys, like we said, we saw a red day today, which makes the technicals on this index look a little bit different than the ones we just saw in the SPX. But just like the SPX, I talked about this one in yesterday's video and on Friday's video. And we were talking about this channel that it was trading in between these two red trend lines, right? Just like the SPX, we've been uptrending since around the 26th of December in 2018 in the Dow Jones as well, right? And over these past 20 days, we've been trading in this channel. We can see the support where we bounced there on four separate occasions. But where I'm saying here, why I'm saying rather, it's looking a bit different than the SPX is because we can see a slow formation here of a head and shoulders pattern, just like the NASDAQ here in the Dow Jones, right? We can see the left shoulder, the head, and the right shoulder slowly start forming. And the fact that we did have a red day today and these candlesticks are pointing down really makes it look more bearish in general, because not only is it a head and shoulder, it's also making lower highs here, right? The high at 25.40, the second low at about, or the second high, lower high at around 25.259, the third one at around 25.175, and it looks like we got the fourth one today at around 25.137. So unlike the SPX, guys, you know, we do see a bit of a head and shoulder pattern more in process, or more in progress rather, than the SPX here on the Dow Jones, right? Because we got that dip. But tomorrow, the SPX can also be in a head and shoulder pattern if we break this support that we talked about a couple of minutes ago, right? Let's say tomorrow we break below here. That's going to be a head and shoulder pattern for the SPX as well. But we need to wait for that break of the support, right? So the Dow already looks like it's forming that head and shoulder pattern with the red day that we had today. We're slowly breaking that trend line right now to the downside. So this could be the start of more selling off tomorrow, you know, in terms of the Dow Jones, based off the technicals that I'm seeing right now. So judging on the Dow Jones, guys, it does seem like we are breaking to the downside. But another thing I want to point you guys to on this longer term chart, it does point to us having more potential bullish, you know, upside in the Dow Jones due to the 50 SMA breaking above the 180 SMA here, which we talk about in pretty much every video, you know, that being a very bullish sign. So keep an eye on that, guys. You know, it really could go either way right now, you know, judging off the longer term technicals and the shorter term technicals. But, you know, if we do see that break, guys, I'm pretty sure, I'm pretty positive, you know, we're going to see some more downside if we do end up breaking more into the $24,000 range. You know, that's going to be a good pretty much sell-off trigger in my personal opinion. That might trigger, you know, some more sell-off in terms of the Dow Jones here. And just like, you know, the Dow Jones, guys, the NASDAQ is looking like it's forming that head and shoulder pattern as well. Although this one, out of the three, this one and the SPX is still technically, they're still technically in that uptrend because unlike the Dow, we aren't really seeing a break below the support trend line here on the 20-day chart, right? We're pretty much still holding that 50 SMA as a support here. We're still holding a higher low from the previous where it did bounce on the support of the trend line. So, you know, the continuation of the uptrend is still looking pretty solid right now. But another thing I want to point you guys to on this 20-day, one-hour chart is this cross of the 50 SMA below the 180 SMA, which is a bearish sign, unlike what we just saw on the Dow, which is a bullish sign, right? You can use this both ways, right, to really figure out, you know, where we could be headed in the short term and the long term, either down or up, right? This is a very good way of, you know, signaling bullish or bearish, you know, sentiment and signs in terms of stocks through price action, right? So, you know, tomorrow, guys, keep an eye on this support. You know, if we break this and start pushing down and completing this head and shoulder, you know, that's going to be a good sign that we could potentially be selling off more in terms of the NASDAQ, right? So here on the 180 four-hour chart, we can honestly see the head and shoulder even better, right? Even more clear on this chart. And again, we can see that we're still trending, you know, in this, you know, channel here. So keep an eye on the support of this channel. Are we going to break to the downside or are we going to continue to the upside? And of course, the tech sector, guys, tech stocks do have a pretty heavy weight on the NASDAQ. So let's say tomorrow when Apple, if Apple or Facebook do very well, if they bounce back strong since they didn't have a good day today, you know, we could see a big push up to the upside in terms of the NASDAQ. So now that we got a brief little analysis of what's going on in the overall markets, my personal opinion, some key signs, some key technical indicators, voice crack, some key technical indicators that we, you know, pointed out, let's talk about what I ended up trading today. So what I ended up trading today was UWT and Tesla, guys. I'm actually in an overnight swing trade in Tesla. We're going to talk about that in a couple of minutes. But first, I took a day trade today in UWT after we saw a very big sell-off today in crude oil. And for those of you guys that don't know, crude oil is you know, a future. This, what we're seeing right here, /CL, light sweet crude oil futures. These are futures that UWT and DWT trade based upon, meaning whenever crude oil is going up in price, UWT is going up in price as well, right? And whenever DWT is going up in price, that means crude oil is going down in price. So today, you honestly could have played both sides of the spectrum, right? You could have played the sell-off here in crude oil from about $52 down to around $51.20, right? Which DWT, if we look at that chart, did very well this morning, right? We can see the pre-market push from around, you know, $9.90, $10, all the way up to $10.73. That's a very, very big move. And of course, we could have played the opposite on the downside, which is what I personally ended up doing, playing UWT. And to be quite honest with you guys, I missed the opportunity here in terms of DWT on this sell-off. So what I wanted to see today is I wanted to see if we were going to fill the gap back to the upside for a potential day trade in UWT. Because typically, guys, not always, but when these futures fall a drastic amount in a short period of time, there's always an opportunity for them to build some momentum back to the upside, to build that RSI back a little bit, for people to slowly start buying back in to push the price back up, right? Because, you know, we've seen charts that sell off very quickly and they don't seem like they're coming back up, right? But a lot of the time they sell off a ton, right? They find a bottom and then they show some push back to the upside. So my ideology behind this trade was to get in on the upside in UWT. And what do we see here, guys, which is a huge sign of a bullish reversal? we see a double bottom here, guys. A double bottom is what we see, which really issues a potential reversal to the upside for a stock, ETF, future, you know, indice, whatever, right? So we see that in crude oil, the first bottom at around 950, the second one at about 1120, and then we start to climb back up. And this is when I ended up trading UWT for a gain, right? Not only did I see the double bottom here, which is a good reversal to the upside, but we also saw the EMA break above the 50 SMA. We saw the candlesticks break above the 50 SMA quite quickly, honestly, and then we started to break above the 180 SMA. So I started to build a little position here, in UWT at around this time period. We can see this double top, or double bottomed rather, as well. And right around here, guys, I ended up slowly getting in. I believe I put my first order in at around 1205, ended up adding a little bit more money. This was a longer term day trade today. Typically my trades with day trading are more scalp trades, very quick, you know, a couple minute trades, but this one actually stemmed over about an hour, right? So I got in here initially 1205, ended up getting in a little bit later on at around 1220. So my average position was around like 1212 or something right now at this particular time period. And then I ended up setting a once I started to get in the profit, I set a trailing stop loss, which is very important when you're already in the profit, right, to keep those profits if the stock ETF ends up falling down. Because if you don't have a trailing stop loss, and let's say you're up around, let's say $100 on your position, and then it quickly turns to the downside, you can lose all of that money if you don't have, let's say, a 1% or a 0.5%, you know, trailing stop loss when you're already up 1, 2% on your position, right? So I ended up making a trailing stop loss, right, as I was getting into the green here. Then I ended up just selling off my position, you know, up around 2.3%. So you guys know that, you know, I'm mostly a conservative trader. I'm cool with, you know, 2-3%, you know, on any particular day, on any particular trade, right? I ended up getting out right here. And, you know, 2% may not seem a lot to a lot of people out there, but I personally like trading with a, you know, a smaller conservative strategy where I can consistently profit and not always chase those home run trades where, yeah, you can make a ton of money, right? But you can also lose money, right? Last year or 2 years ago at this point, I lost about $2,000, you know, chasing an overnight trade on Drip, right? I talked about this in a video. If you guys want to watch that video, I believe it's called My Biggest Trading Mistake or something like that. Just type in mistake in the channel, the word mistake, and you'll probably find that video. But I pretty much talked about that where I ended up blowing, you know, 40%, 50% of my position. I lost like $2,000. This was about a year and a half, 2 years ago from now. And, you know, ever since then, guys, that really taught me a strong lesson. And you know, I've been really just playing it very conservative, and I have tight rules on myself where I never hold, you know, these 3x leveraged ETFs overnight ever, right? I never ever hold these overnight. But pretty much, guys, that is the gist of this trade here in UWT. And now let's talk about my little position that I built in Tesla today, guys. So Tesla is another one that we talked about in yesterday's video. And this one, guys, ended up doing exactly what I wanted it to do, right? We were talking about it in yesterday's video on Sunday. The stock was at around $305 when we were talking about it, $300, $305. It was right here exactly at $305. And what I was saying, guys, in that video is I wanted to see Tesla break into the 315, or really the 310 to 315 level for the continuation of the uptrend and for me to add a position in it. And that's exactly what we ended up seeing today. So if we take a look at this 20-day chart a bit closer, I wanted to see the bounce on this support level of the trend line before hopping in. We see the bounce today, which is a very good sign of the continuation of the uptrend, and that is why I ended up adding in money into Tesla stock today. And let me tell you guys exactly where I ended up adding this money. So I didn't add it on this initial pump up. We saw it pump up to nearly 320, which is a very good sign, guys. A very good sign that it's continuing to push up, continuing to uptrend. And the good thing I liked about this is that we ended up pulling back to around 310 at the close, and we ended up holding the support from the morning, right? So I ended up taking a little position, a couple of shares here, towards the end of the day, and I'm planning on swinging these as long as this uptrend stays intact, right? So my target right now, guys, on Tesla, let's say tomorrow, you know, we end up bouncing here on the support and pushing up even more, potentially breaking 320. That's ideally what I want to see. You know, I'm going to be adding more money into Tesla once we break out of there. So right now, I'm in at around $300 and I'm in like 313, 314 range. And again, like I said, do plan on adding more money once we break, or if we break out of this 315, 318 resistance. And ultimately, guys, let's say we do bounce here. That's going to be the continuation of the uptrend, because that would be a higher low from the previous, which is a higher low from the previous. And really, the trend's going to look something like this if we do end up bouncing and pushing up here, which is what I ideally want for this trade. So right now, my first limit sell is at around 323, actually at about 322, just a little bit under this previous resistance, right? So the plan right now is to get in, or I'm already in at 313, but to add a little bit more money tomorrow, if it continues to uptrend, then end up selling at around 323, which, you know, let's say my average cost is at around 316. It won't give me the biggest gain, right? It's not the biggest gain ever, but it's around a 2, 3% swing trade. And of course, if we plow through that resistance, I'm going to be holding those shares a bit longer, you know, waiting to see if they do end up filling that gap, maybe to 330, maybe to 335. So drop a comment down below, guys, if you're still watching this video. What did you end up trading today? I'm in Tesla, and I personally traded UWT today. So last time I traded Tesla, I actually took a little loss. So let's hope this time the trade ends up working well. And another thing I want to see, guys, now that we pulled up this 180 chart very quickly that I almost forgot to mention, is I want to see a break out of this 180 SMA on this 180 chart here, which would be a good sign that we're continuing to uptrend. But, you know, pretty much, guys, that's what I ended up trading today. Let me know down below what you traded. So let's take a look at the weed stocks very quickly, because we do see some of these reporting earnings this week. So let's take a look at some of these technicals very quickly. We do see here Cronos, ticker symbol CRON, C-R-O-N, one of the hottest marijuana stocks out there. This one does seem to be forming the head and shoulders pattern that we talked about yesterday, right? We talked about this yesterday. It's kind of like a deformed head and shoulders a little bit here. The left shoulder, the head right here is the right shoulder. But with them having earnings this week, guys, who knows what can happen, right? CRON could literally shoot back up to $25 in the matter of one day. I honestly would not be surprised if this shot up $5. Am I saying that's going to happen? Absolutely not, right? There's a very, very, very slim chance that that does happen, right? But with the marijuana stocks, the way they've been moving, I'm just saying, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we moved 10, 15, 20% back to the upside, or, you know, if we sold off down to $15, $16, $17 in terms of CRON, I also would not be surprised as well. So CRON, guys, keeping an eye on this one as a potential earnings play either to the upside or the downside, but I'm personally waiting till after earnings. I don't trade and hold stocks really before their earnings report. I mostly wait and see the reaction afterwards and try to grab some of that action afterwards. So CRON, guys, that's what it's looking like. CGC, very strong sell-off here, guys. We're trying to hold above that support here at around $42. But if we break that, expect way more downside here in terms of CGC. And also keep an eye on this potential 180 SMA support at around $38, $40. That could be a potential bounce spot for CGC. But as of right now, you know, if we do end up holding this support here, guys, and we slowly start to fill the gap back up to, let's say, $45, $46, which was a previous resistance, distance, you know, that could offer around 6% profit in terms of CGC. So NBEV today, guys, down around 2%, down around 14 cents, is still holding that 180 SMA support, which is a good sign, but we would want to see a little push up to around 650 at least, maybe even 660 before adding a position into NBEV as a short potential trade. Apple's another one I was talking about. This one is also looking like it's forming quite a head and shoulder pattern here. How many times have we said head and shoulders in this video, guys? It feels like a lot of these patterns are looking like head and shoulders. This one's a little bit deformed as well. But, you know, if we break this 180 SMA to the downside, or this 50 SMA rather to the downside, more selling to come in terms of Apple and Facebook here, guys. It's looking pretty bearish. We do see a little head and shoulder forming as well. We could be headed back down in terms of Facebook. So drop a comment down below, guys. Let me know what you are watching for tomorrow. I would love to know if you guys got this far in this video. Drop a comment and let me know you got this far. I really do appreciate all you guys watching and all of you guys sticking for the entire video. It does mean a lot. I'll catch you all in the next video. Have a great night. Peace out.